Abstract. This is my blog. First entry: is the future of marketing deterministic? Second entry: is Big Brother watching? Third entry: is organic search more effective than paid search? First entry: 7 minutes 8 seconds. Second entry: 2 minutes 47 seconds. Third entry: 5 minutes 24 seconds. If I total all this, it is 15 minutes and some seconds extra. I think 25 to 30 seconds more. Means 15 minutes and 25 seconds is approximately the timing of my entire vlog. Thank you.
Good afternoon. My topic is the future of marketing deterministic? This is my argument. Okay, so let this be a multiple choice question. The options are A, yes, option B, no, option C, I know but will not answer, I will fold my hands and relax, D, I'm not sure. My option I will tell you at the last, but your option you can post it in the comments. So first, let's have some thoughts on the future. Means I will share some of my thoughts on what can be the future of the marketing. So I will use an ancient theory to support my argument, that is 4 P's of marketing: place, product, price and promotion. Place. Let's start with place. What do we mean by place? Okay, channels, logistics, transportation, inventory. Logistics means, you know, those route matrix algorithms and all those sort of things. Transportation means mode of transport, maybe sea cargoes, trains, airplanes. Inventory means using the protocol to, you know, store stuff, like just-in-time protocol and such thing. Okay, so now when we talk about future of place, I will say, you know, social media ahead. What is happening? What is the average time spent on the digital media? This is a very old stuff. It's almost 2010 to 14, so we might be spending more time now. But just observe. Okay, these are hours basically. On an whole, we are spending, like, you know, in at least 5 hours on our digital devices like mobiles and laptops. And when we add TV, radio, and, you know, print and all those stuff, then almost on an average 12 hours per day we are spending on the digital media. So the place factor is changing. Now we are no more roaming in shopping malls, or, you know, walking around in streets, or, you know, we are doing that, but we are not doing that more. We are spending more time on the digital place. Okay, so this could something like this could be our future. Okay, who knows? So the question comes: the future of place, can we predict it? Now let's come down to product. What's a product life cycle? Introduction, growth, maturity and decline. But how is the product scape changing? What are the factors that are changing the product scape? The first thing that comes in my mind is 3D printing. Okay, printing cool stuff. Okay, like there's this beautiful, you know, footwear being printed in this particular 3D printer. Okay, so when we talk about 3D printing, the first question comes is, what can we 3D print? Okay, so we know we can print sculptures, prosthetics, accessories, ornaments. What can we not 3D print? Okay, let's hold on to that question for a while. But the question is, what will be able to 3D print in the future? Okay, so maybe yes. So as far as the future of 3D printing is concerned, sky is the limit. Okay, the next thing that comes in my mind for the product scape, the future of product scape, is recycling. Okay, we are going into a age of recycling where we might see this, you know, robots specially designed to do recycling. You know, this will change the product scape that we are seeing now. So again, the question comes, the future of product, can we predict it? Okay, now what comes in my mind is obviously price. Okay, so what are the different types of pricing strategies? Penetration pricing, skimming pricing, competition pricing, and premium pricing, and so on. Cost-based pricing, and so on. So let's light. It's too heavy. Let's lighten up a bit. Okay, see this. Okay. See this. Okay. So when we talk about the future of pricing, the thing that comes in my mind is dynamic pricing. Okay, so what is basically dynamic pricing? Dynamic pricing is basically determining the price of a product or service at a real time. Okay, for me, a thing might be 0.80 pounds. For someone else, it might be 1 pounds. For someone else, it might be 1.2 pounds. So it's determining the price at a real time level. So that's the future of pricing, but according to my perspective. So again, the future of price, can be predicted. Now, when it comes down to promotion, I will call promotion the king of marketing. Okay, or the pilot. And the rest 3 P's are passengers. or the active one, and the rest 3 P's are passive ones. Do you agree with me? Post in the comments. Okay, so when it comes down to future of promotion, I see the following possibilities. One is this, you know, like these days, special 5-second pre-roll ads are made for YouTube, something very creative like this. Okay, so, you know, we might see very short ads in future. You know, these days even the TV spots are of at least 40 seconds, so that might change. Okay. Again, virtual reality, augmented reality. This might change the, you know, the way that we do promotions. Space advertising. If this happens on a large scale, this might change the entire scope of promotions. Okay, and this is just the beginning. There is so much more happening. Okay, as far as space advertising is concerned, there was one company, Space Marketing Incorporated. They wanted to place billboards in the space, but there was a huge controversy and they were opposed, and so they couldn't move forward with the project. Pepsi did a brilliant ad campaign in space. You know, they spent $5 million for it. Even Pizza Hut had a brilliant ad campaign. They delivered pizza in the space, and obviously they, you know, made an ad out of it. So again, when it comes down to the future of promotion, can we predict it? So again, it comes down to my core argument. Is the future deterministic? Is it predictable? Can it be forecasted? So it's all about order versus chaos. It's all about determinism versus randomness. So I will take help of these guys. Okay, so Heisenberg's uncertainty principle. What does it say? That we can either exactly know the position or the momentum, but not both. Okay, this is the uncertainty principle. Okay, again, a very brilliant question. Is light a wave or a particle? So as we can see, there is so much uncertainty and randomness, and that has some support, some evidence. But when it comes down to order, we don't have much evidence. Okay, so let's come down to very specific topic that I started with, predictions in marketing. But what is basically marketing? Can we call it a social science, a pure science, an applied science? Okay, so I don't think it's a pure science, because it's biology, physics, chemistry. I don't think it's an applied science. That's basically engineering. So can it be a social science? So if it's a social science, see the thing over here. Okay, basically, from many marketing theorists and social science theorists, predictions in social sciences are possible, but they are not precise. Still, precision has not been achieved. Or we can simply shut off this science chapter and say marketing is basically an art. So if marketing is an art, in art we don't do predictions. Okay, as such. So my stance is the future of the marketing is not deterministic. What do you think? What is your stance? Please tell me in your comments. Thank you.
So my argument is Big Brother watching? I will take you through some of the privacy policies. Firstly, Pinterest's. So what are they collecting? I'm just taking you through some scary parts. Okay, I'm not going through the entire policy. They are collecting our log data. Whatever we are typing, they are collecting. Okay, isn't it scary? Second, let's go to LinkedIn. See what they are doing. Messages. Whatever messages we are doing, private messages to our friends, to our colleagues, to our boss, they are having access to it. Okay, let's go to Twitter. What are they doing? Personalization across devices. They know even about our device information. Whether we are accessing Twitter through our laptop or our mobile, they know it. Now let's go to the father of social media. Facebook. What are they doing? Okay, see, where are they collecting our information from? The Facebook services, the Facebook family of companies, means WhatsApp and whatever. And also services provided by other companies, such as if there is some like symbol on some other website, they will collect information from that website also. Means they will be having a cookie on that website also for sending our information back to Facebook. Now let's go to mother of social media, Google. Okay, what are they doing? They are doing a lot of scary things, but especially when we are using Google account with domain administrators, like we are using our Shorton ID, it's actually Office ID, but if you want to open our email ID in Google, we will have to use an Exchange account. In that case, it's called a domain administrator. What they can do, our domain administrators, they can view all the statistics about our account, they can change our account password, they can suspend or terminate our account, they can access all the information, means they have access to all our mails, they can retain all our mails. Okay, and they can even restrict our ability to delete or edit any information or settings. Means they can restrict us from changing any privacy settings, and worse, they can restrict us from changing our mails or changing our contact information or even accessing our mails. This is the scary part. So see what we are leading to, our world is leading to this. Is Big Brother watching? Yes, he's watching you. He's watching you on a regular basis. I'll finish off the argument by showing you a small clip. Good evening. So my argument is organic search better than paid search? Firstly, let's understand the difference between organic search and paid search. Okay, I go to Google, I search a query by soap. Okay, I get following results. Can you see the sponsored over here? See? This is paid search. Can you see the ad written over here? Yes, this is paid search. Rest all is organic search. Okay, same. I search a query for sell soap. See, sponsored, this is paid search. This is paid search. The rest all stuff is organic search. Okay, the same applies to this query, best soap. Okay, the sponsored is the paid search. So this paid search comes from something called Google AdWords. Okay, you have to basically pay to Google AdWords to place your search over here, you know, at the top. Like for example, someone would have this iHerb would have paid Google to place its query at the top when someone searches for buy soap. That is called paid search, and these organic search are the natural results which are derived by Google's algorithm, and they are sent to us. So always what happens is this: the first query has topped the Google algorithm. Okay, then the rank 2, rank 3. So these are basically ranks. These are basically ranks as per the Google algorithm. Okay, so let's see the query soap. Can you see something over here? Can you observe something? There are no paid results over here. So Google has not allowed any advertisement on the query soap. The same applies to the query recycle soap. See, there is no paid results over here. Google has not allowed anyone to buy this particular keyword. Okay, the some keywords are reserved like soap and recycle soap where nobody is allowed to advertise, and some keywords nobody bothers to pay money to, so they don't have any paid results. So only some queries contains paid results. How many percentage of queries contains paid result, we will see later. Okay, so this is the basic difference between paid result and organic result, or let's say paid search and organic search. Okay, now let's see some statistics between them, the difference between them. Okay, let's see organic search versus paid search some facts. Okay, almost 3.5 billion searches per day are done by us worldwide. Okay, now searchers click on the organic results 85% of the time. So only 15% of the time people are concerned about paid results. Organic listing is between 2 and 6 times more visible than the paid one. 100% of the searchers look at the first organic result, while only 50% look at the first paid result. Remember the, you know, buy soap thing? The first organic search, 100% of us will look at it, but the first advertisement, 50% of us might skip it. 50% look at the 7th organic result, while only 10% look at the 7th paid result. See the drastic difference? Okay, now 50% of the queries in Google show no paid results at all, like we saw with the reserved keywords like soap and recycle soap, and some keywords who no one bothers to pay money for, but organic results are obviously in 100% of the queries. Okay, now if a brand appears, now there is something interesting. If a brand appears both in organic and paid results, it is open 92% of the time. While if it is only in the organic or only in the paid, it is open only 60% of the time. Okay, so this is one interesting fact. Okay, so this shows the significance of organic results, organic search. Why? Because organic searching, organic result is very easier to obtain and very cheaper to obtain as compared to paid. Okay, now let's see how the organic results can be obtained. That is, can be obtained by using Google Trends. Okay, so this is a Google trend for the keyword search. See the interest over time. So we can see that interest is depleting these days. Okay, while it was very high during summer. Okay, so people are more bothered about soap during summer, while people are less bothered about soap during winter, searching about soap. Now where the interest is more: Philippines, Jamaica, Nigeria, Trinidad and Tobago, Uganda, Okay, and then you can go Ghana, Kenya, US, UK. UK is at 9th rank. So in UK also, soap is very important as far as the search queries in the Google are concerned. This is all organic search. Nothing is paid over here. Okay, and so you can see, you know, how it is going, you know. See, these are the ranks. Okay, so in this particular list, the last is Argentina. Okay, now see, these are related topics, means what topics related to soap people are searching more, and these are related queries. This is very important. Dish soap is first, second is soap opera, third is black soap, fourth is best soap, and fifth is bar soap. So none of the initial queries which we searched for, like soap, recycle soap, buy soap, sell soap, came over here, right? Those are the natural things that will come in our mind while making a website, that let's put these queries, buy soap, sell soap. But those are not the top queries being searched by us. So when you want to do search engine optimization, when you want to be the top website in the organic search, you have to include these keywords in your website, and then your website will come at the top. Okay, so this is how organic search can be obtained. Thank you. Appendix. For me, the major concern is to show engagement, because I don't have any references to write down, because as it's a vlog, I have written my references on the images itself wherever required, and wherever it is a capture video, the links, if I have borrowed content from it, it is visible on the top. So I have no intention of doing any plagiarism, and I have been to my best honest to you. I don't have any intentions of plagiarism. Any unintentional mistake is truly unintentional. Okay, so to proceed with the engagement, Facebook group. First entry, is the future of marketing deterministic? 4 likes and 1 comment. Thanks so much for your sharing. Your content is insightful, and I am also think you are knowledgeable about so many fields. You talked about 4P, 3D print, and I am so impressed that you combined Heisenberg's uncertainty principle with marketing. You guide me a new way to use other knowledge of different subjects to analyze some marketing issues. Thanks a lot. Second entry, is Big Brother watching? 2 likes. Third entry, is organic search more effective than paid search? 1 like. Now, going to the YouTube channel. This is my YouTube channel. Okay, the time at which I am recording the engagement is 12:44 PM on November 14, Tuesday. Okay, so this is, will be locked in at that time. I am refreshing this. Okay, my first entry, is the future of marketing deterministic? Okay, so there are 54 views and there are 3 likes. Okay, my second entry, is Big Brother watching? There are 17 views and there is 1 comment. Interesting topic. I do think that our privacy is being severely invaded, and they are using it to get money without our permission. But next time, can you put subtitle? You are talking too fast. I cannot get all information. Okay, I have a reply for you. In my third video, means my third entry, is organic search more effective than paid search? I have taken your feedback into consideration and have been as slow as possible. I have been much slower than as compared to my second video. Okay, over here I have 7 views. Okay, so this is all my engagement. You can see all, you know, all about this. I tried to put this in Google Analytics, but this thing is not working. I even removed the query because, you know, Google Analytics does not accept the queries, but still it is not showing, you know, it's not showing, it's not reflecting on this. And when I'm trying to put this particular videos, you know, where I had like, you know, this 55 views, it's not able to catch up and show the you know, various analytics, you know. So I tried, but it didn't work. Okay, so this is all about my engagement, and as I repeated, I have no intention of any plagiarism. And, you know, like I have like, for example, if you, what I said earlier, that, you know, about putting things, for example, when you go to my first entry, now this thing is obviously written by me, everything. Like, for example, if any image I'm using, so I'm writing image copyright, it's from Time magazine. You can move on and see the same. See, so according to the marketing portfolio, and I'm doing it everywhere, you know. Even if some obvious images I'm using, like, you know, for example, any image like this, like, you know, then also I am writing over here, you know, the image is from where, you know, it's from Eiffel.Paris. Sometimes it's visible, you know, like here, like it might go through, but you know, I have written it here, you know, it just went down, that, you know, image is from somewhere else. You know, so over here also it's going down, or it's not high, it's not visible, but if you see, its image is from Daily Mail, and so I have done that. And when it comes down to my second video, for example, this one is Big Brother watching. So some things, like, you know, wherever I'm borrowing material from, they're obvious. Like, for example, over here you can see the link is there, so I'm using the privacy settings from over here, and this is this privacy settings of them are not copyrighted, they are for public use, so I'm just analyzing them. And when for example, this thing, when I started with, you know, this obviously it was made by me, is Big Bro watching. But for example, when I use this image, this is not mine, okay, it's again wherever it is from, it is from this particular link. And again, when at the end I show this video, this particular video is not mine, it's a video called The Future of the Internet, it's by someone else, but it's really good. But you know, as I this can be considered as a direct quote in written material. So this particular 20 second clip is the only direct quote in my entire vlog, otherwise everything has been constructed by me and spoken by me, okay. And when it comes down to the third entry, so what happens is, whenever, like, if I'm using any statistics, these are again the, you know, like the Google searches basically. And wherever, suppose for example, I'm using, see I'm writing the source from where it is, you know, here I'm writing the source at the beginning, so I have done this, okay. So this completes my appendix of explaining my engagement, and the references are already in the video, and it also explains my intention of not doing plagiarism. Thank you so much for watching my blog. It was a very, very fun experience, and you know, I enjoyed it. Thank you.